Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has laid out his expectations of the new cabinet. And for one minister, the Minister of Heritage, regulating online speech is a key priority. In the mandate letters given to ministers and made available to the public, the mandate for the Minister of Canadian Heritage features a policy that really seems to be rooted in the online hate study that the Justice and Human Rights Committee did shortly before Parliament rose before the election. This is what the mandate letter says. I will expect you to work with your colleagues and through established legislative, regulatory, and cabinet processes to deliver on your top priorities. In particular, you will create new regulations for social media platforms, starting with a requirement that all platforms remove illegal content, including hate speech, within 24 hours or face significant penalties. This should include other online harms, such as radicalization, incitement to violence, exploitation of children, or creation or distribution of terrorist propaganda. Now, this task falls on the new Heritage Minister, Stephen Guilbeau, a first-time member of Parliament who has a long-standing track record in environmentalism. In fact, his official biography on the Prime Minister's website lays out his role as leading the charge in the fight against climate change for several years, and also founding a large environmental organization in Quebec and working with Greenpeace. But now he's the guy that is going to be regulating social media companies who don't remove content from the internet that the government says they must remove. Now, I want to make very clear that I don't think this is a problem when you're talking about markedly criminal speech, like terror propaganda, like child pornography, like incitement to violence. The problem is that also included, specifically named, is hate speech. Nowhere do we have a cohesive definition for hate speech outside of the criminal code, except the government has tried to broaden that. This is what happened at those committee meetings in the last spring and summer, when the government was hearing from experts who said that things that are offensive about certain religions or ethnic minorities but aren't criminal should still be prosecutable by the government. And this is going to be very dangerous. We had for a while on the book Section 13, a law that allowed internet hate speech to be prosecuted by the Human Rights Commission, even if it fell below the threshold for criminal law, which is very high and justifiably so. If you don't have a definition of hate speech that you're prepared to make public, you are risking a threat to free speech. And this is where the government has flirted with in the past. Nowhere in the mandate does actually defining hate speech appear, and this needs to happen before we can have any significant regulation of it. Take a look at another item that was in the mandate letters. This one, part of the mandate for Bill Blair, the public safety minister. Work with the Minister of Diversity and Inclusion and Youth and the Minister of Justice and Attorney General of Canada to combat online hate and harassment and continue to invest in resources to counter the rise of ideologically motivated violent extremism and terrorist organizations. So we now have an online hate file that is spanning at least four different ministers' portfolios and still no definition of online hate. And the devil is, as they say, always in the details. If Canadians want free speech to be upheld, this definition has to lean on the existing criminal code definition of online hate speech and not one that's created to encompass things that might be politically incorrect, things that might be offensive, things that might be very difficult to hear or see people say, but are nonetheless protected by free speech. And this means any work they do in this file needs to be followed very closely and very carefully. And the opposition, who still controls the committees at this point, needs to not let this get by unchallenged. This is something that True North will not waver on. As an outlet, we support free speech. As an individual, I support free speech. We are going to be providing a voice on this and other matters as well that the mainstream media is not. We can't do this alone, though. If you can chip in to support our efforts by joining my Heritage Club, there's a link in the description box, and it's very much appreciated. For True North, I'm Andrew Lawton.